We're underway to the Mariana Trench, the deepest valley in the world, summoned by a Biont alarm. The monarchists operate their geothermal power station in the trench, converting magmatic energy from the Earth's interior into electricity. The geology of the Earth's crust is particularly unstable there, and Admiral Wojciech Ping suspects the Biont are trying to exploit this fact to set off an undersea quake. News has come through that the raging battles in the Red Sea have cooled down. An undersea quake of catastrophic magnitude destroyed the stations and habitations of the Clans Union in the Arabian Sea. No survivors. I've seen it before. The right displacement of the Earth's crust and a powerful tsunami arises, stirring up the sea, sucking the polluted surface layers into the depths. No one can survive. It's becoming clear that these undersea quakes are not just whims of nature. The Ronin Kung Lung called the Biont evil from the depths. The Moks talked of the growling from the depths. I'd bet my last credits that they're right. The undersea quakes are being intentionally unleashed. The devil only knows what machines the Biont have that can mobilize the very crust of the earth against the people of Aqua. I don't like jobs that take me into Shogun territory. Years ago, I supposedly insulted His Majesty, and after a rigged trial, I was sent to a penal colony in the Sea of Okhotsk. Thanks to the Ronin Hunglung, I was able to escape. Nobody has ever seen the Shogun Emperor Lung in person, but that simply makes him the most powerful phantom on Earth. He is feared, loved, and honored by his subjects, though some are said to be dissidents. It seems to me as if everybody here is in lockstep. For the strong ones, there are only two courses. Climb as high as they can in the officers' corps, or run.
Svestovostok, capital of the Shoguns, 1,649 meters. Sonar ready. Navigation point reached. Target locked.
Don't pay attention, this will be our last stand.
Hopper's turret detected. Target destroyed. Target locked. Target identified. Target destroyed. Target locked. Target locked. Target locked. Target identified. Target destroyed. Target locked. Target identified. Power surge detected. Target destroyed. Target Vesta Vostok, capital of the Shoguns, 1,649 meters. Sonar ready. Target locked. Target destroyed. Target locked. Vostok, capital of the Shoguns, 1,649 meters. Thank you. Power surge detected. Battleships of the Atlantic Federation. Challenger, geothermic power station, 5,402 meters to 10,039 meters. Power surge detected. Target identified. Target locked. Target identified. Target lost. Target locked. Target identified. Target destroyed. Navigation point reached. Target identified. Target locked. Torpedo ready. Target locked. Target lost. Autopilot available. Target locked. Target destroyed.
The Bionts were clever. Not even our smallest robotic rescue unit can dive that deep. A slightly built man might just be able to squeeze inside, but nobody could breathe down here at a pressure of 1,200 atmospheres. It would take too long to design and build a machine that could take over rescue operations in this abyss. I've got an idea.
Challenger, geothermic power station, 5,402 meters, to 10,039 meters.
I'm sitting with Admiral Ping in the research station of the Challenger area, looking at the blurred documentary film of the evil, designated by military personnel at the naval base as Servian. Servian, Surviving Union, is the name of the bioelectronic entity off the coast of Australia, which has entered into a symbiotic union between organic and mechanical electronic substance. Its boats form a single gigantic neuronal network, the center of which lies in the command center off Australia. That's why they're so hard to combat. The Bionts don't steer their boats. They are the boats. Sooner or later, we'll have to stab directly into the Servian's bridgehead and destroy its command and guidance center.
Progress. Research station, 822 meters. Battleship of the Atlantic Federation. Thank you. Sonar ready. Navigation point reached. Torpedo ready. Target locked. Target locked. Target locked. Target locked. Target Navigation point reached. Autopilot available.
The Waterman has no shoulders. He's genetically constructed to allow fluid forward motion in water. He breathes gas or liquid equally well due to his gill-lung membrane breathing system. His ribcage collapses according to the pressure at a given depth, compressing the volume of the lung wings down to a few milliliters. All gases have escaped from his bodily systems. He breathes an oxygenized and heliumized solution of carbon located inside his thermal dive suit. It took a while before we got the signal from below. The watermen had secured the bomb to the cable. We slowly started to pull it up. Done. Incredible relief. The helium of our breathing gases never smelled better than it does now.
Polar, battleship of the Atlantic Federation. Sonar ready. Target locked. Target locked. Target locked. Target destroyed. Target destroyed. Target locked. Target destroyed. Target identified. Target locked. Battleship of the Atlantic Federation.